I don't like cheats at the best of times. And of all the tables in town, they have to pester mine. But this one was different. Really barefaced. I could see him coming from his first step on my staircase. Now, usually, I'd have the lads throw him right on the street. But I just wanted to see what made him think I was weak. The cheek of him, leering in spite of his smile. Trying to take a chance on a night on the tiles. He had the fake presence of a boaster that spins up. His starting bet was 10 large. Picked the A, cleared his rack in the first turn with violet. 78 points inspired hate. I was quaking with anger, but had to keep it contained. Or knew he was cheating, just needed to figure his game. Anyway, a few moves in, cocky still earning. I threw down cheek to see if it had unnerved him. He carried on, showing no signs of nervousness, his confidence superfluous. I started feeling murderous. That's when my gaze caught his hand on the bag. And I thought, there's no way those letters are being randomly grabbed. I dismantled his blag, seen through his simple tricks. He'd been feeling about reading the letters with his fingertips. So what happened next meant he'd never get his smile back. I chucked aside the table and garroted him with my tile rack. Sorry. I don't get to speak like this openly. It becomes emotional for me. I brought you this. Bit of Dean Martin. Keep you going for the week.
Watch the sunrise.
Hang in there, son. Go check on you tomorrow.
Jones. He doesn't like that name. Harry likes scones and Scrabble games. He lives and breeds languages, eats them like cucumber sandwiches, brandishes the bones of the foes that he vanquishes. I languish in this beast's den. An old school gangster moved to Manchester from the East End. In this world of madness, he's the one with the least friends, and it's no secret that that's how he keeps it. With your life in his palm, he'll be the quickest to cease it.
Screw you. Get me that behique, would you? I'll fancy a smoke.
All the old cohevers before the big game. Do you remember that bloke? What was his name? Back in the 80s, hungry for a fix. You put one of those out in his eyes and covered him with tiles so he couldn't cross the sticks.
Ha! Baghead Billy. I still remember the smell. Burnt flesh and cigar tobacco with no admittance to hell. Those were the days. Well?
Sorry, Harry.
How many times have I told you not to get safety matches? Is there money secure in a safe?
Everything's in place.
Tiles all there?
Yeah, and I brought a bag of spares.
What about the clotted cream and cream cheese?
I milked Daisy this morning. The stump is the bee's knees. Put yourself at it. Breathe deep. Shall we begin?
Get me some water. It's warm.
I know you're no fools. For health and safety's sake, I'm going to go over the rules to avoid trouble. Points for first word are double. Each bettor will select one letter to see who plays first, A being the best and Z being the worst. Harry to play first. Play will pass to Harry's left, clockwise. All eyes will stay on their own racks. There will be no verbal or other attacks on the other people playing, or on me, your referee. When your turn is finished, you will replenish your rack with tiles from the bag. You must always have seven. All words must be in this dictionary, and any challenges will be settled by me. Nothing capitalised, nothing apostrophised. Abbreviations only if regularised, like radar and scuba. House rule. No words that intend to offend or corrupt. Mother is fine, but not mother...
Fight!
In the bag are 100 tiles, 56 consonants, 42 vowels. 9A, 2 B's, 2 C's, 4 D's, 12 E's, 2 F's, 3 G's, 2 H's, 9 I's, 1 J, 1 K, 4 L's, 2 M's, 6 N's, 8 O's, 2 P's, 1 Q's, 6 R's, 4 S's, 6 T's, 4 U's, 2 B's, 2 W's, 1 X, 2 Y's, 1 Z, and 2 blank tiles. These last may be for any letter replaced, but attract no score wherever they're placed. I will declare an end to the game when no one can play or when no tiles remain, but the value of any tiles you still hold will be deducted from your score before the winner is caught. Highest score wins. For the purposes of security, we have on the door Nathan and Paul. Both big and bald, you're apt to lose your balls if you misbehave at all.
A dainty thing, the Scrabble game. With tiles and rack, you rack your brain. To win, you have to use your head. Yet this is where gangsters flock and sip their tea with hands on glocks. Be careful how you choose to tread. No hasty moves or disrespect. This game requires intellect to win. You have to use your head. And always think one move ahead.
Are there any questions? Then let's play Scrum. Harry to move first. Whisk, 40 points.
Not bad, but it looks like I'm about to whisk the lead from right under your nose, old bean.
Tyler Burr, a bluffer. A hustler, always mashed from his cocaine stash, or flawed from the bourbon he keeps on pouring into his glass. So how can this drunken junkie surpass the Scrabble masters? It's gadgets, microchips, mirrors and magnets. The codes combined with coca lines means foes are blind to the tricks of his sleeve. Better gadgets than even Ian Fleming can see. Seductively weaving words into a net, Tyler's never been beaten yet. Whiskers, 54 points.
Is that all you got, sunshine?
The sunshine on one's face. Car shadows on one's shoulder.
Triple whip. A Scrabble idol. A true professional. The biggest threat at the table. A wolf in wolf's clothing. Devoted to hunting the fold and disposing of weak sheep. Just last week, he wiped the floor with Yakov Davor, a final score of 6-8-4. The man had never been beaten before. His roar of pain met with a growl of disdain from the real tiger of the game. Triple would give up his life for the board. Before his death, his dying breath would strive to remind you that words is an anagram of sword. As he plays, he looks bored, but his focus is deep. His unique triple threat technique is impossible to beat. Shoulder. 89 points.
Impressive. So, blank slides. The so-called virtuoso of vocabulary. I've been waiting a long time to see if your lexicon is as limitless as they say.
Blank slate. Real name, Jerry Numbera. A man to beware of. He's rare. A serious genius. Knows every probability, automatically, lexically, and mathematically. He makes Rain Man look like a layman. His game is so good, this intellectual hero's been barred from every Scrabble casino from Canberra to Reno. A lean, mean Scrabble machine, a new boy on the scene, walking away with all the accolades and awards. Blank is known for his century scores in a single play. Now everybody's waiting to see what Blank Slate's first move will be. Whisk. We, 5 points.
I knew it was too good to be true.
So, the Scrabble Underground. The most renowned players around gather together to pan out Harry's plan, the biggest game since Scrabble began, for the highest stakes. It all started with me and Harry baking.
You're now
his son, but he loves you. You're nobody's
your son, but he
cares. You may be king, you may possess the world and its gold, but gold won't bring you happiness and your
bloody easy with that salt! Just a pinch!
Sorry, Harry. He's very particular about his scones. So there we were, mixing dough in a bowl, when...
Scrooge! Will you change that bloody ringtone?
Scrooge, or go to hell. All right, say what you're saying and say it fast. I'm baking and... Well, I'll cut to the chase. Work for you? Ha! I'd rather... That can't be true. I want proof.
What's that? Scream behind, what's that?
Nothing, just the facts. You know, before you retired, how many cheats did you cause to expire?
There was loads. There was that young fraudster from Clapham, who went by the name Morgan Rackham. Oh, I hacked off a wreck with a board sharpened edge, and a blood left a wonderful pattern.
And in your casino at Lord's, that cocky Frenchman, Georges Lebon.
I shoved tiles down his throat till the little frog croaked and sent him to play with his lord.
And was it the one you garrotted?
I remember when that cheat got spotted. He... Pour me more tea.
Two lumps?
No. Three.
Do you never miss those old games? Getting all the big names round the table? Playing for crazy high stakes?
Not really.
It's a real money maker.
And why would I need any more cash? Oh, excuse me. I'm going for a slash. It's gone right through me, that. I've got the bladder the size of an axe.
Just, that fax says Jack the Rack is hosting a match.
Jack the Rack is a little rat. Why should I care about that?
Well, he says, your games, in your heyday, compared with his now, are like a nursery playdate. Says his games are more than unmissable, and if yours were the stuff of legends, then his are purely mythical in the mental and the physical. And based on this information, I'd say Jack the Rack's getting above his station.
I shouldn't waste him. I'm Harry Jones. Jack the Rat was a spring chicken when I made my bones. You know what? I miss the old games. Getting all the big names round the table and playing for crazy high stakes.
Really?
It's a real money maker.
And why would you need any more cash?
Oh, I could never have a big enough stash. Jack the Rat wasn't even around in my heyday. My game, that's a replay, eh? Based on this new information, I'd say Jack the Rat's getting above his station.
You're wasted.
No. I've got a better way to deface him. If?
Yes?
I've got an idea. I want you to set up a big game. Get in the big names. I'll put up 1 million, and the pricing is 250 large. You'll be in charge of the purse strings. And ensure the game's played straight. This will show Jack the Rack who's the real heavyweight.
Oh, Harry, your ideas are great. Better than I could contemplate. Brilliant suggestion. We'll do. No question. I can see it up here. You at the head of the table, where you belong, with me alongside you. I'll have to go out on the scout, Find out who's up and coming, who's worthy of playing you, sharing your table. Three of the finest, most skillful wordsmiths. Three heavy-weighted crucive herbalists. Three worthy opponents for you to demolish. I'll get right on it.
It's a feast. And at the risk of having to remain anonymous, it's the bourbon industry.
cocktail that makes it upon us.
I know who you are, Tyler. And Andy, I'm a man of simple pleasures, and measure your best brand, you'll be fine.
No, the pleasure's all mine. You think you know me?
Oh, not wholly. Only as a master of the rat tiles and board. There's not an opponent for miles you've not floored. Or so I've heard.
So you're a word freak too?
Not me. Though I know one who'd like to beat you. In a game next week, high stakes. Only the best, no one knows. I ask on behalf of a man named Harry Jones.
The Hackney Hacker?
A grisly moniker that does little to flatter, but yes, he's my backer.
Well, I'd love to, mate, but I'm afraid next week I've got a bit too much on my platter.
I thought you were having a week off.
Yes, Andy, I am, but a man as wicked as me never really has any rest to speak of.
Well, it's an afternoon game, so you won't miss your lie-in. And you only need a modest fee of 250k as a buy-in. Harry's putting in a full mil.
My beating heart beats still. A 1.75 million pot. As a master of understatement, I'd say that's a lot. But I haven't got that sort of cash floating around. If I did, I think I'd have found a better use for it than a flutter on the tiles, gee. Besides, my competition days are behind me.
Really? You surprised me. I heard only last week you beat Tommy the Tank Sherman for a cool $100. Now, you might lose, but what if you won? A smooth seven-figure sum would mean you could repay your father's capital stake in your company.
All right, stop fronting me. How the hell are you talking my business, rude boy?
Bless you, Tyler. You're like a child with a new toy. Pretending it's yours when everyone knows you bought it. Your self-respect isn't even manufactured. It's imported on ships that bear the crest of your daddy. But if you answered the call to this quest made by Harry, you might have a chance to prove your youth's not so callow and finally step out from Warren Senior's shadow. Everything's falling into place. Do you know, I'm rather enjoying the chase. Yeah, I can hear you. Loud and clear, almost as if you're in the same room. I need to go. I'll speak to you soon.
And you join us, back at the burned-out shell of the Salford Working Men's Club, for the Scrabble World Series, brought to you by Mattel, with me, Hans Schnell. And it's a rather tense moment. Jerry, blank slate numbera, is about to break the defense of his opponent. He puts down component for a 50-point bonus, beating Vin Bigley with superhuman focus. Now he comes to his game with Tylovsky, the Russian. Boulder for 70. Oh, that certainly crushed him. So he comes to his final board. The room falls quiet. If he breaks his record now, there's sure to be a riot. And he puts down everything as his final word. Blank slate has come first, second, and third, beating three champions simultaneously. Vin Bigley, Carlos Bingo Sanchez, and Boris Tylovsky. Now the lovely Jemima presents a prize with a value far more than monetary. This lovely, gold-leaf, leather-bound dictionary. And as if that wasn't enough, this exclusive, limited edition Scrabble mug. So, from me, Hans Schnell, our sponsors, Mattel, and of course, the lovely Jemima. Oh. Goodbye, thank you for watching, and be fell.
Is it true? Every single word in the English language, every combination of seven letters and the highest scoring words that can be gleaned from them.
Embedded,
emblazed, the perfect logical mind.
You are?
Doesn't matter. You've got an interesting pseudonym.
Blank slate.
Nothing.
Everything.
Well, what's a man like you need a dictionary for? I know a way you could get a much higher score. Harry Jones is hosting a game next week. High stakes. A 1.75 million pot.
All right, mate. Well, it's better than this lot. You must think I'm a right mug. And this is practically worthless.
Wait, my friend, we're barely scratching the surface. I have limitless funds at my disposal, and I'm willing to share them. I have a proposal. points.
Hey, don't mock me. I'm just being a cockney like Harry, keeping it real with Jenny Neal.
Is that really the best word you could have played?
Hey, don't worry about me, mate. I've got it made.
Read and reeled, 19 points. Vi, 7 points. Maths and vies, 29 points.
That reminds me of Johnny Sawjoints. Scroobier, you remember that game? He tried to tip the balance. I threw down maths and he responded with a challenge.
I know Johnny, he's like a tent without a pen.
That's what brains as rheumatic as his legs.
Points! No swearing at my table! Are you playing or what?
I am, Harry. But you have no idea what sort of game I've got.